do its job for taking on the government for its failure on Corona. If and when this government goes and India does get rid of PM Modi, what is the way forward on Kashmir? I mean, I know that it's kind of, you know, on the margins given what's going on in India, but it is an issue that has existed for so long between our two countries. What is it that can be done, that will be done, if there's a change in the government? Thank you so much.
Shahzad, thank you. You know, it's nice talking to you. I sincerely believe that what is the dangerous to this society is the religious fundamentalism, whether it's the Hindus or the Islam or the Christians or Sikhism, whatever. Religious fundamentalism leads to hatred, and hatred leads to violence, and violence is the ultimate in all acts of terror. So therefore, I think the malice and the disease and the virus is the religious fundamentalism. Every society, every religious group has to realize that everyone has a right to follow the tradition and follow the faith which he's adhered to. No one has the right to impose his faith and his feelings and his religion on anyone else.
Democracy was not there in Kashmir when they revoked Article 370. Then insaniyat was not there because they put everyone behind bars. And Kashmiriyat is something which is basically the fundamentals of secularism. Because in a Muslim majority state, there was a Hindu Raja, and both worked together. In fact, the reservation in Kashmir was given to the Kashmiri Pandits in government services. So therefore, the decision of revoking Article 370 and reducing the statehood of JNK is extremely, I would say, sad decision. And the Congress party would certainly have to have a relook on this issue.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shahzeb. Next.